cancer has survived thousands of years that human beings have been living on this earth.
While we say cancer is one disease, it really is thousands of diseases.
Cancers grow like gangbusters in the body, but we have had difficulty growing in the lab. We need laboratory models that capture the complexity of cancer. If I'm a cancer patient, what I care about is that the genetic profile of a tumor like mine is captured in today's model collection. Our goal is to enable any cancer patient, anywhere in the United States or perhaps beyond, to dictate that a model of their tumor be derived to be shared broadly with the scientific community.
The National Cancer Institute is making concerted effort to develop new models from underrepresented minority patients so that we can study whether there are any differences in their response of their tumors to cancer therapies that we have. One person's lung cancer is different from another person's, so we actually need models that represent each genetic subtype of lung cancer, for example.
A number of new technologies now exist for reprogramming cells or growing tumors as organoids or as spheres that enable researchers to do new things with tumor samples that they could not have done before.
These new organoid technologies can be very efficient, ranging from 20% success rate up to 70 to 90% success rate of getting a cell line that represents that tumor.
We have cancer models in the process of development, which are very rare, and we now have, for instance, models from breast cancer, ovarian cancers, pediatric cancers. The goal of the 1,000 models of HCMI is just the first step of what can be done.
We see the HCMI as a way to set in motion this process of making ex vivo model derivation, of turning it from a very manual, laborious process into a very efficient, cost-effective factory-style operation.
ATCC was selected as the distribution partner for the HCMI program. We bring in the models from the development centers. We do cell culture, cell sorting, and expanding. We cryopreserve them and do the QC. What comes along with those models is the genomic information and clinical information. And this has a profound impact on the way that these models can be used.
When you can grow pieces of tumors in the lab, then you can systematically test thousands of drugs, and that gives us a complete response map to complement clinical cancer genomics. That's why building these models is so important, so we can look patients proudly in the eye and say, we're doing everything that we can to use a piece of your tumor to drive translational research forward across the international community.